President Marcos hails his first APEC summit as a success. The chief executive said he was able to relay the position of the Philippines on various issues such as food security, climate change, and health. Marcos is also able to meet with several heads of state on the sidelines of the summit, including Chinese leader Xi Jinping, French President Emmanuel Macron, and Saudi Arabia's Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman.
I have discussed many issues with all the leaders of our region, of the Asia Pacific. So that is they now know me, and they know what I'm about. We have discussed things. They know what the Philippine position is on several issues.
Marcos also sharing the credit with former Philippine President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo.
Sinasabi kong secret weapon dahil ako yung baguhan dito. Ako yung unang naging leader. Kaya pagpapasok kami sa meeting, pag nung nakita si Jimmy, ito yung my good friend. Madali na kagad yung usapan.
Before flying back to the Philippines, Marcos also met with the Filipino community in Thailand. There, Migrant Workers Secretary Susan Ople announced that a Philippine Overseas Labor Office will be opening in the country soon. The president arrived in Manila Saturday night. He will again be traveling in December to attend the business summit of the ASEAN and European Union in Belgium.
U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris has arrived in the Philippines for a three-day official trip. This is the first visit to the country by America's second highest official. Harris is accompanied by her husband, Second Gentleman Douglas Emhoff, who earlier came to the Philippines as part of the U.S. delegation for President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s inaugural. They were welcomed by U.S. Ambassador to the Philippines Mary Kay Carlson, U.S. Embassy Deputy Chief of Mission Heather Varyava, Manila's Ambassador to Washington Jose Manuel Romualdez, Vice President Spokesperson Reynold Munsayak, and Chief of Presidential Protocol Adelio Cruz. Pasay City officials also greeted Harris as she arrived at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. Harris is scheduled to hold meetings with her Philippine counterpart, Sara Duterte, at President Marcos today.
Ang pag-uusapan is paano magkaroon ng cooperation or mapastrengthen pa ang cooperation ng Pilipinas at ng United States of America.
Harris will also travel to the province of Palawan on Tuesday to meet residents, local leaders, and the Philippine Coast Guard. Despite Palawan's vicinity to the Philippine-claimed Spratly Islands in the West Philippine Sea, President Marcos believes Harris's visit would not cause any problems with China.
I don't see why they should. She is in the Philippines and she's visiting another part of the Philippines. And of course, it is the closest, our closest area to the South China Sea, but it's very clearly on Philippine territories.
And I check on the weather now. The intertropical convergence zone bringing rains to parts of Luzon and Visayas. Let's hear more from Pagasa forecaster Patrick Del Mundo. Good morning, Patrick. What do you have for us?
Yes, good morning, Ms. Nikki, and to our televiewers and listeners. So the intertropical convergence zone still affects areas of Palawan, Visayas, and Mindanao, while the shear line is affecting the eastern section of southern Luzon. And due to the combined effect of the intertropical convergence zone and the shear line, the Bicol region, Palawan, Quezon, Aurora, Isabela, and Cagayan will continue to experience cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms. While for Metro Manila and the rest of the country, partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers and thunderstorms due to localized thunderstorms. So as early as this morning, there is a thunderstorm advisory raised over Metro Manila, Bulacan, Rizal, Pampanga, Zambales, Bataan, Laguna, Nueva Ecija, Cavite, Quezon, Tarlac, and Batangas. So the said areas will experience rain showers for the next 2 hours. And as of today, we are not monitoring any low pressure area within and outside our Philippine area of responsibility. So we are expecting generally fair weather conditions and in the next coming days. The rains is only caused by localized thunderstorms. And as of today, we don't have any gale warning raised over the coastal waters of the Philippines. So our seafarers and our country fishermen will are safe and safely roam our coastal waters. And that is the latest from the PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. This is Patrick Del Mundo reporting.
All right. Thanks for that update, Patrick.